Welcome back. Well, since 2011, CNN's Freedom Project has been shining a light on modern-day slavery, highlighting victims like Cyntoia Brown, who, as a teenager, was forced into sex trafficking. One night, her actions would eventually get her sentenced to life behind bars. But thanks to the efforts of some pretty high-profile advocates, she's now free. After 15 years behind bars, you're free.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
I mean, it's good. You know, it's a blessing. It's literally a miracle.
Cyntoia Brown-Long has spent half her life behind bars. At just 16, she was forced by her abusive boyfriend into sex work. One night, she shot and killed a 43-year-old man who had bought her for sex. She claimed it was self-defense, but prosecutors argued it was opportunistic after she fled with his wallet and two guns. She was tried as an adult and sentenced to life in prison for murder and robbery. You would have been close to 70 by the time you got any chance of release. How do you deal with that at the age of 16?
So in the state of Tennessee, I had an opportunity for parole, but it wasn't a meaningful opportunity. It was after 51 years I could be considered for release. And as I said, the prospect of that was just, I mean, it was unbearable. I couldn't imagine.
From activists to lawmakers to celebrities, people of all walks of life called for justice.
Before all of the outcry had happened, my attorneys had already been meeting with the governor's office and trying to talk about clemency, which clemency, less than 1% of applications are even reviewed by the parole board in the state of Tennessee. So to say it was slim to none chance of me ever receiving any kind of relief through clemency, that's an understatement.
Singer Rihanna posted about her on Instagram asking, did we somehow change the definition of justice along the way?
Did you understand how much support there was for you on the outside?
You know, for me, the biggest thing was seeing how many people across the world, seeing teachers, doctors, you know, single parents saying, I don't know what to do. I don't know how I can help, but I want to do something.
In the United States, all underage sex workers are defined by federal law as trafficking victims. And now she's helping others understand that.
And, you know, so often we're told that there are just certain young girls who are fast, certain young girls who are promiscuous that ask for these things. And it's important for young girls to know that you cannot consent to your own exploitation. If you can't consent to a sexual relationship with an adult, then you can't consent to them taking advantage of you.
There was another victim here, Johnny Allen, and his family feel like they're victims too. They lost someone. What's your message to them, given that they feel the justice system didn't work for them?
I feel horrible about what happened. I feel horrible that they're still having to live with this.
In a statement, they said, our hearts are broken because we feel like Johnny never got to defend himself. We never got to be a voice for him. Cyntoia Brown-Long is not entirely free. The newly married 31-year-old will still have to report to a parole officer for the next decade, on top of holding down a job, performing community service, and undergoing counselling.
You know, from the time that they told me I'd do life in prison, I never believed it. I always thought that one day that I would be free, and I held on to that, so.
You kept the faith.
I did.
She really is now working to help others in similar situations. Well, thanks so much for watching CNN Newsroom. I'm Lynda Kinkade. World Sport is up next with Patrick Snell.
And we have a packed show as well. Liverpool fans are pretty happy tonight, I tell you. Premier League title is just around the corner, you think.
I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, I'll be sticking around to watch.
Well, you better. The more the merrier. Happy New Year, by
happy
the way.
New Year, yeah. To you.